Dear students, you know, I am Rega Surya Rao, principal retired aided law college Maharashtra and author of so many law subjects which are in good circulation all over the India and abroad. I started delivering lectures online since March 2018 after my retirement for the benefit of law students. In the first instance, I have taken up 5 subjects: contracts 1, torts, constitutional law 1, IPC, family law 1. In my previous classes, I delivered 2-3 lectures on IPC. Number 1, importance of the subject. Lecture number 2, importance of the subject, elements of crime, stages in crime in one lecture. Second lecture, jointly and constructive liability, section 34 and 149. And in this lecture, this is third lecture. In this lecture, I wish to take up general defenses. when an individual has committed a crime, even though guilty is proved, when guilty is proved, he will be punished. But before awarding punishment, the accused person will be given an opportunity to get exemption from the criminal liability. So such exemptions are explained in general defenses. As already told you in my previous class, Indian Penal Code is a substantive law of crimes. Indian Penal Code is substantive law of crimes. Law of crimes is broadly, basically divided into 2 categories. First part is, first category 1 is substantive law of crimes, that is Indian Penal Code. Second one is procedural law of crimes, the Code of Criminal Procedure 1973. Substantive law of crimes, that is Indian Penal Code, is a general law, main branch of criminal law, main code. There are so many special legislations on criminal law, like Dowry Prohibition Act, Prevention of Corruption Act, Cosmetics Act, Weights and Measures Act, so many special legislations are there. But Indian Penal Code is main act, main code, general branch, general law. It was codified in the year 1860 and came into force on 1st January 1862. At the time when it came into force, it contained 488 sections divided into 23 chapters. Today, that is as on, there are so many amendments. As on till 2013, there were 76 criminal law amendments. There are three amendment acts which inserted 3 chapters: chapter 5A, chapter 9A, and chapter 20A. By inception of these 3 chapters, the number of sections rose to 511. Now, Indian Penal Code contains 511 sections divided into 26 chapters. The new 3 chapters are 5A, which inserted section 120A and 120B, which speaks about criminal conspiracy. 120A defines criminal conspiracy. 120B prescribes punishment for criminal conspiracy. Chapter 9A, which contains section 171A to E, deals with election laws, offenses against election. Chapter 20A, which contains only one section, 498A, which deals with cruelty by husband and collaterals against a married woman. This is our sketch. As I told you, Indian Penal Code contains 511 sections, and section 1 to 75 provide for various provisions relating to general principles. In simple words, section 1 to 75 deal with general principles. Section 76 to 95 deal with various general defenses. Section 76 to 106 lay down various provisions relating to general principles. Section 107 to 120 deal with abatement. No, I repeat once again. Section 1 to 75 deal with general principles. 76 to 105 deal with defenses and general defenses. 107 to 120 deal with abatement. 120A and 120B is sometimes general principle, sometimes specific offense. 121 to 511 deal with various specific offenses. This is the sketch of Indian Penal Code. In previous classes, lecture number 1, I explained in detail about what is crime, what are the elements of crime, what is the significance of mens rea, what are the stages in crime. The topic I had explained in detail. In one lecture, I explained joint liability, joint and constructive liability, that is common intention and a common object, in one lecture. This lecture, I want to discuss about various general defenses. There are section 76 to 106 deal with various general defenses. However, out of these, three are most important from examination point of view. Number one is insanity, section 84, private defense is another important defense. The other things in right of private defense and insanity are main important topics which may be frequently asked. Other topics are small topics. Sometimes most of the time they are asked as short questions, and occasionally they may be asked as essay questions also. Now I want to let you know what are these various defenses provided for under section 76 to 106 of the Indian Penal Code. So what do you mean by defense? Defense is a weapon with which a criminal can invoke exemption under criminal liability. Defense means general exceptions are also known as general defenses. Defenses mean, suppose an individual has committed a crime. Suppose it may be murder, rape, kidnap, theft or whatever it may be. Whether he has, before guilt is proved, he is accused. If guilt is proved, he is called convict. When once guilt is proved, he will be convicted and he should be sent to jail for imprisonment. But before awarding him punishment, the judge, so beyond all reasonable doubts, it is proved beyond all reasonable doubts that the accused is guilty of committing a particular crime. It may be murder or culpable homicide, or rape, hurt, grievous hurt, theft, robbery, dacoity, whatever it may be, if guilt is proved, he is about, before giving him punishment, before awarding punishment, the judge will give him an opportunity to get exemption from criminal liability. If the accused person is able to establish any one of the defenses available to him under the Indian Penal Code, under section 76 to 126 of the Indian Penal Code, then he will be exempted from liability. That means he can escape from liability. Defenses, general defenses are, general exceptions are those with the help of which a person who is about to be convicted after guilt is proved will be able to escape from the criminal liability. That is what is called general defense or general exception. Like that, I told you, Indian Penal Code contains 511 section. Section 1 to 75 deal with principles. 76 to 106 deal with general defenses. 107 to 120 deal with abatement. 120A and 120B new sections. Sometimes criminal conspiracy is the principle. Sometimes criminal conspiracy can be filed against criminal conspiracy as a specific offense. And section 121 to 511 we deal with various specific offenses, namely offenses against public tranquility, offenses against election, offenses against state, offenses against human body, offenses against property, offenses against marriage, like that. There are so many specific offenses which we are going to discuss one by one in due course. Among all specific offenses, culpable homicide and murder, rape, kidnapping, abduction, hurt, grievous hurt are very important from examination point of view. Now I want to take up general defenses. Under this general defenses, general defense or general exemption is one with the help of which an accused person who is found guilty of an offense is provided with so that he may be able to get exemption from the criminal liability. So already the magistrate or session judge has decided, it is found that that particular person accused is guilty of a particular offense. It may be theft, robbery, rape, hurt, grievous hurt, whatever it may be. But he is about to be convicted. But he will not be convicted. He will not be awarded a punishment directly. Before awarding punishment, the accused person who is found guilty will be given an opportunity to get exemption from criminal liability. Such opportunities are called general exceptions or general defenses. Now, I repeat once again, section 76 to 106 lay deal with different kinds of general defenses. Now, number one is, out of these, insanity, intoxication, right of private defenses are very important from examination point of view. Now, so first one is a mistake. Section 76 and 79, these two sections provide for mistake of fact and mistake of law respectively. Mistake of fact and mistake of fact law respectively. What is mistake? Mistake means something done unintentionally, erroneously, an act or omission committed ignorantly, innocently, without having guilty mind. That is called mistake. This mistake, all these defenses I am explaining you in brief. They are very easy. You can go through from any book. You will be able to understand, because I have to deliver lectures, so many lectures on so many subjects in a very short span of time. So I will show you the way, what is what, so that if you read any book, you will be able to understand very clearly. From examination point of view, with this knowledge, if you read any book, you can successfully face the examination. Now, first one is 76 and 79. These two sections deal with mistake of fact and mistake of law respectively. There are quotations. What are the quotations? Number one, ignorantia facti excusat. Ignorance of fact is excused, excusable. Ignorantia non juris excusat, mean ignorance of law is no excuse. This means ignorance of fact excusat, means ignorance of fact is excusable. Ignorantia juris non excuses, non excusat. It means ignorance of law is no excuse. If there is ignorance and without knowledge, lack of knowledge, ignorance of law cannot be excused. Ignorance of fact is excused. So on this particular point, I explained in brief R versus Prince case, R versus Tolson case. In R versus Prince is a young boy. He was in love with a girl, a minor girl. He was in love with a minor girl. He took her away from the lawful custody of her parents in order to marry. Meanwhile, the girl's parents lodged a complaint for kidnapping. Actually, it is abduction. If child is taken away, it is called kidnapping. Kid means child, nap means taking away. Kidnapping means if a child is taken away, it is called kidnapping. If an adult person is taken away, it is called abduction. So like that, the prince, an young man, fell in love with a girl below the age of 16 years, but she appeared to be above 18 years, but her parents lodged a complaint. Then prince was charged for kidnapping or abduction. Then the court, prince said that I do not have any guilty mind, I don't have any evil intention. I am in deep love with that girl. She told her she is above 18 years. She appears to be above 18 years old, but I did not know that she is below 16 years of age. Though I took her from lawful custody with good intention to marry her. But the court did not admit his contention, because there is a rule. Taking away an unmarried girl below the age of 16 years itself is an offense. Whether good intentions or bad intention is immaterial. Whether menstrua is present or not, it is immaterial. So I explained in last class, an act itself is no wrong unless menstrua is present, unless it is done by guilty mind. An act itself is no wrong unless conquered by guilty mind. Suppose in accident, the driver has no intention to kill a pedestrian. Accidentally, accident took place and some pedestrian died. In this, in a driver's mind, menstrua is absent. It is an accident. If it is inevitable accident, there is no negligence is proved on his part. He is exempted from criminal liability under Section 80 of the Indian Penal Code. Suppose if there is a negligence, he negligently drove the vehicle and dashed the pedestrian, causing his death by speaking to his friend over cell phone or in a drunken state or looking this side or that side, then it is a negligent accident under Section 304A. He will be punished up to 3 years imprisonment. That is there. It is an inevitable accident. He doesn't have any accident. Some unexpected thing took place. He got some heart stroke or some insect enters into his eye or something unexpected took place. It is an inevitable accident, as in the case of Padmavati versus Duganayaka. Then it is inevitable accident. He is exempted from criminal liability under Section 80. So now the thing is, mistake of fact is excused, can be excused. Mistake of law cannot be excused. So, the mistake of law relevant case is Prince case. Mistake of fact relevant case is R versus Tolson. In Prince case, mistake of law, Prince, Mr. Prince said that he doesn't know that taking away an unmarried girl below the age of 16 years itself constitutes rape, constitutes kidnapping. So even though if a girl below the age of 16 years gives consent for intercourse, that constitutes rape. Constitutes rape. If the girl below the age of 16 years gives consent to go away with the boy to get married elsewhere, that also is, that consent is no consent. It amounts to abduction or kidnapping. So these are the things. Mistake of fact. An act itself is a guilty, so there is no question of guilty mind. The act itself is guilty, against law. So whether mens rea is preferred, in several cases mens rea is present, the person is liable. If mens rea is not present, the person is not liable. That question does not arise. So mistake of, in Prince's case, mistake of law is no excuse, but mistake of fact is excused, as in the case of R.V.S. Stalson. In what happened, Mr. and Mrs. Tolson got married to Mr. Tolson. Sometime after marriage, her husband went for sailing on ship. The ship in voyage met with some shipwreck, and so many months elapsed, and it was learned from all reliable sources that the ship in which Mr. Tolson bound for voyage met with shipwreck, and the ship was drowned. All the persons and crew in the ship were presumed to be dead. So, having heard that her husband presumed to be dead, and she waited for 7 years. If any person whereabouts of anybody are unknown for a period of 7 years, that person is deemed to be dead. Mrs. Tolson waited for her husband beyond the period of 7 years. Having waited 7 years, the whereabouts of her husband were unknown. Then she presumed that her husband died in shipwreck. Then she got remarried. Sometime after remarriage, when she is living with the second husband, the first husband, Mr. Tolson, appeared and filed a case against her for bigamy. Bigamy means getting married during lifetime of the spouse. If a woman marries again during lifetime of the husband, or a man marries again during the lifetime of the wife, it amounts to bigamy. But Mrs. Tolson was charged for bigamy, offenses against in UK. She was found guilty and was awarded 1 year imprisonment in trial court, but she preferred appeal before the court of appeal. The court of appeal quashed the 1 year, 1 day imprisonment. In trial court, she was awarded 1 day imprisonment. In court of appeal, the one day imprisonment was quashed. Because in Tolson case, it is mistake of fact which can be excused. She was exempted from criminal liability. With mistake of fact is a good defense. Mistake of law is not a defense. So this is first point. The second one is Judicial Acts, section 77 and 78. 77 speaks about what are the criminal acts done in discharge of judicial office. Suppose the magistrates, session judges award punishments. Whatever for punishment causing injury or damage to the aggrieved person, they are not liable. Suppose the session judge awards death sentence, and that person is confirmed by High Court. Thereafter, death sentence is executed. The session judge is not responsible. He is not responsible for the death of the session judge. Doesn't have any criminal liability for the death of that convicted person who has been hanged. Similarly, whatever punishments are given, through that whatever punishments are awarded, in that process whatever injury, loss done to the criminals, the persons acting in judicial office are not responsible, they are totally exempted from the criminal liability. Next one is section 78. So section 77 refers to officers of judiciary, judges, magistrates, and section 78, all the persons who are connected with discharge of judicial office. Suppose persons who are acting in response to the judgment delivered by the court, in that process issuing summons, arresting police officers, means whatever may be all court employees, police officials, prison authorities who are discharging their duties and causing hurt or grievous hurt whatsoever may be, then they are not responsible, they are exempted from the criminal liability, section 77 and 78. Next one is section 80. Section 80, accident. First defense is mistake of fact and mistake of law. Mistake of law is a good, mistake of law is no defense. Mistake of fact is defense. Second one is section 77 speaks about judges and judicial magistrates are protected under this, and all officials who are acting in response to the judgments and orders, writs issued by courts, all directions given by the courts, who are the persons, police officers, court officials and others who are acting in discharge of their duties in response to the court orders, they are also exempted from the liability. Next 77, 76, 77, 78, 79 is over. Now section 80. What is this section 80? Provides section 80 speaks about accident. Accident is a defense. Suppose a person is driving the vehicle carefully, in spite of driving the vehicle very carefully, due to suddenly tire burst or axle from axle tire is dislodged from axle and the vehicle got toppled and dashed to pedestrian and somebody died. It is an accident. It is an inevitable accident. It cannot be avoided. Suppose while driving the vehicle, some insect enters into the eye of some mosquito or ant or whatever it may be, enters into him, suddenly he moves, in that process some accident comes. Some accident occurs. So any suddenly somebody rushed into, drove negligently and approaches him in order to escape from that vehicle collision, he takes a sudden turn. In that sudden turn, in order to save some others and save himself, he dashed somebody on the road. An accident took place. In that particular accident, there is no any negligence. In that particular accident, there is no any intention. Means he is absent, that intention of that accident is totally inevitable, uncontrollable, unavoidable beyond all reasonable care and skill. That accident is called inevitable accident. If such accident is there, the person is totally exempted from the criminal liability. Even that accident causes death of one person, more persons, or hurt, grievous hurt, whatsoever may be, the driver of the vehicle will get exemption from the criminal liability. Suppose if the accident is inevitable accident, as in the case of Padmavati vs. Doganayaka, the jeep's vehicle dislodged from axle and toppled down, and the person, the stranger who took lift, met his fate, died. Then for that, when natural heir filed a case against the jeep owner, he is not liable. That is inevitable accident. So suppose while driving the vehicle, the driver is negligent, having drunk, having consumed some alcoholic drink and driving the vehicle negligently while speaking to some TV or cell phone or while driving the vehicle is speaking to his friend, whatever it may be, he's driving the vehicle negligently and carelessly, and negligence is proved, he will be liable under section 304A, a punishment up to 3 years imprisonment. That is there. Now, this is the thing. So, if in a not negligent, if it is intentional accident, there are some accident, the accident, there are some accident, they are not intentional, they are not accident, they are intentional killings. In some movies, we see that the villain takes the vehicle intentionally in order to kill the hero. Or so similarly, there are so many cases, there are some cases wherein they will be shown as accident, but actually they are intentional killings. So if it is that, if a person takes a vehicle intentionally to kill somebody, to run over him, that is treated as culpable homicide or murder, depending upon the circumstances of the case. So accident is another example, another defense. Next one is necessity. Necessity 81. Section 81 provides another exception. That is, section 81 provides some exception. That is necessity by compulsion. Necessity. What do you mean by necessity? So there are some circumstances necessity arises in order to save a lot. For example, the fire engine service, they received some accident, they received some telephonic call stating that fire took place in a locality. Unless the fire engines reach there, hundreds of lives will be sacrificed. So in order to save hundreds of lives inhabited in that particular locality, they may apply excessive speed. On the process, one or two persons on the road dies. It is not countable, it is negligible. That is what is called necessity. So another thing is, there are tiled houses or thatched houses. There are tiled houses, and one house caught fire. In order to prevent the fire, in order to put down the fire so that it should not be extended to all the houses. One or two houses may be put down, they may be destroyed. Suppose house number 1 to house number 100. First house caught fire. In order to prevent fire, house number 2 and 3 can be collapsed so that the fire can be extinguished there itself, so that it cannot touch house number 4. Suppose it is, if house number 2 and 3 are not put down, the fire extends to house number 4 to house number 100, all the 100 houses will be destroyed. In such case, in necessity or compulsion, case is filed, the person who put down the houses can plead the defense of compulsion, and he is exempted from the criminal liability under section 81 of the Indian Penal Code. Next, section 82 and 83 of Indian Penal Code provide for criminal exemption and on the ground of infancy. Infancy means children. A child below the age of 12 years is an infant. Infancy also is a good defense. Suppose a child below the age of 7 years commits any crime. It may be theft, or it may be murder, or any crime. It may be murder because a child below the age of 7 years doesn't know anything. He takes a sharp knife and kicks it with another child with a knife or an elderly person who is sleeping, whatever it may be. So a child below the age of 7 years commits any crime, that child, boy or girl, is totally exempted from the criminal liability. That is on the ground that is an infant. Suppose section 82, under section 82, a child below the age of 7 years is totally exempted from criminal liability. But section 83 speaks about criminal exemption in respect of a child between the age of 8 and 12 years. 8 and 12 years, subject to proof of mens rea. Subject to proof of mens rea. What is this? Suppose a child below the age of 7 years is presumed to be immature beyond all reasonable doubts. That is why a child below the age of 7 years is totally exempted. But there is a we cannot say that a child between the age above 7 years and below 12 years is not that much innocent. A child below the between the age of 8 years and 12 years is expected to possess some knowledge. That child is able to know the nature and extent of the consequences it is doing. So in one case, a child between the age of 8 and 12 years intentionally killed the father when who is about to kill his mother, like that. So if but subject to proof of mens rea. What do you mean by mens rea? Mens rea means guilty mind, evil intent. I already explained in detail about mens rea in previous class. An act itself is no wrong unless conquered by guilty mind. Suppose in accident a man drives the vehicle, while driving the vehicle an accident occurred, some 100 persons are killed, but he is exempted from liability because mens rea, evil intent, is not present in his mind. So he has no desire to kill those people. So mens rea is absent, he is exempted from liability. If there is negligence, he is brought under section 304A and punished up to 3 years imprisonment. So if it is inevitable accident, he is totally exempted from the liability. Like that, if mens rea is absent, no criminal liability. If mens rea is present, liability. So here, if below 7 years, whether mens rea is there or not is not taken, between the age of above 7 years and below 12 years, it will be decided if that child is having mens rea, guilty mind, he will be punished. If there is no guilty mind, that child will not be punished. So this is what is called defenses available to a child below the age of 7 years under section 82. Defense available to a child above 7 years and below 12 years under section 83. Now the next, these are very simple things, they may be asked as short, but the next important next topic for discussion is section 84. In this particular class I will explain all the topics in brief, all the defenses in the brief. In next class I will explain in detail about section 84, insanity, 85-86, intoxication, and 96-106, right of private defense. These three topics are very important from examination point of view. I will, they may be asked as essay questions. Now, what is the next topic is 84. 84 means insanity. Insanity means unsoundness of mind. Unsoundness of mind. Unsoundness, that is some mental disorder, mental disease. So just like a mental man or woman, a man or woman who is mental, who is having abnormality of mind, who doesn't know what is right, what is wrong, who is not in a position to distinguish between right and wrong. So because that is, if that mental man or woman removes the clothes in nude body, he or she may come out. They don't know if he or she cannot come out without clothes, because that is mental condition is that they don't know what they are doing. So abnormality of mind, they do not have any consciousness, they don't have any, that is some insanity is a particular kind of disease. It is it arises out of idiocy, lunacy, or other some mental disease. So those who are suffering from that particular mental disease will undergo treatment in mental hospitals. So that is an insane person. If an insane person commits any crime, that insane person is totally exempted from criminal liability. What is insanity? When this insanity was from when what are the laws of insanity? what are the rules of insanity, when the rules of insanity were framed, formulated. The rules of insanity were framed by House of Lords in England in famous McNaughton's case. What is the McNaughton's case? What is the judgment of House of Lords in UK? What are those rules? What are the reasons for giving exemption to, from criminal liability to an insane person? These points I will take up in detail in next lecture. And that is insanity means if a man or woman is mad, unsound mind, unsound person, abnormal with suffering from mental disease, he or she doesn't know what is right, what is wrong. He is not able to know right and wrong. He is not able to know and understand the consequences of the act he is doing. For example, that mental man or woman will climb a tree and cut the tree, cut the branch where he is seated. So if the cut after cut, if he is cutting the tree, where cutting the branch of the tree where he is seated, he or she doesn't know when the cutting, if the that branch is cut, that man or woman will fall down along with that branch, because a wise man, sane man cannot do it. So he cuts the tree, cuts the branch of the tree where he is seated. So they don't know what is right, what is wrong. On this ground only, due to some mental disease, due to some abnormality of mind and all these things, the insane person or unsound person is totally exempted from criminal liability. Next topic is intoxication, section 85 and 86. What is intoxication? Consumption of alcoholic drinks. Because naturally every person is presumed to be sane. Generally all are sane persons. Sometimes some persons who are suffering from mental disease, they are insane persons. They come within the meaning of section 84, insanity. Suppose sometimes the sane persons, sound minded persons also will become unsound or insane due to influence of consumption of some alcoholic drinks or drugs or other reason. So practically speaking, a man who has consumed, a man or woman who has consumed excessive volume of alcoholic drink, brandy, whiskey or whatever it may be, beyond the control, beyond the capacity, we cannot say the consumption capacity varies from 1% to 1%. One person can take 1000 ml, one person can take 500 ml, one person can take 200 ml. They will not be out of control. But if they consume alcoholic drink, they get out of control. They become out of control. Similarly, drugs are injected. They don't know what they are doing. They will be, their mind would not function properly. They do not know what they are doing. Similarly, apart from this, though not relevant to this, a man who has excessive desire on a particular position, he may get prepared to do anything. Recently in one serial, that woman, she wants to become Rajamata. She wants her son become prince, king of that empire. She committed so many crimes. She wanted to kill all his near and dear ultimately. So that is one type of, she got intoxicated with the power desire, desire of power. So a man who is having excessive desire to occupy a throne, that also he behaves like an intoxicated person. He doesn't know what he is doing. Similarly, a man who has got excessive sex in mind, excessive sex, he doesn't know relation, whether he or she doesn't know, forgets about relationship, forgets about age and so many things. Because we are seeing in the recently in newspaper, there are so many ఈ ఇన్స్టెన్సెస్ ఆఫ్ రేపింగ్ ఏ చైల్డ్, 5-year-old చైల్డ్ వాజ్ రేప్డ్, మైనర్ గర్ల్స్ ఆర్ రేప్డ్ బై ఏ 5-year-old చైల్డ్, చిల్డ్రన్ ఆర్ రేప్డ్ మీన్స్ దట్ మ్యాన్ ది రేపిస్ట్ ఈజ్ ఆల్మోస్ట్ అన్సౌండ్, హీజ్ మైండ్ ఈ సఫర్డ్ ఫ్రమ్ ఈజ్ నోవే లెస్ దెన్ ఎన్ ఇన్సేన్ పర్సన్, ఈజ్ నోవే లెస్ దెన్ ఎన్ అన్సౌండ్ పర్సన్, ఈ హ్యాస్ సమ్ సీరియస్ మెంటల్ డిసీజ్, దట్ ఈస్ వాలంటరీ మెంటల్ డిసీజ్, నాట్ ఇన్వాలంటరీ. సో లైక్ దిస్, సో నార్మలీ ఎక్సెసివ్ కన్జంప్షన్ ఆఫ్ ఆల్కహాలిక్ డ్రింక్స్, ఎక్సెసివ్ కన్జంప్షన్ ఆఫ్ డ్రగ్స్ అండ్ ఎక్సెసివ్ డిజైర్స్, ఎక్సెసివ్ సెక్స్ డిజైర్స్ మే రిజల్ట్ ఇన్ అబ్నార్మాలిటీ ఆఫ్ మైండ్ ఇన్ దట్ ప్రాసెస్ ఎ మ్యాన్ మే కమిట్ దిస్ థింగ్. సో ఇన్ సచ్ సిచ్యుయేషన్ దట్ మ్యాన్ ఆర్ ఉమెన్ డజంట్ నో వాట్ హీ ఆర్ షీ ఈజ్ డూయింగ్, దే ఆర్ నాట్ ఇన్ ఎ పొజిషన్ టు డిస్టింగ్విష్ బిట్వీన్ వాట్ ఈజ్ రైట్ అండ్ వాట్ ఈజ్ రాంగ్, దే ఆర్ ఇమ్యూన్ ఫ్రమ్ దే ఆర్ నాట్ ఇన్ ఎ పొజిషన్ టు అండర్స్టాండ్ వాట్ ఈజ్ రైట్ అండ్ వాట్ ఈజ్ రాంగ్, దట్ ఈజ్ వాట్ ఈస్ కాల్డ్ అబ్నార్మాలిటీ. బట్ సో ఫార్ యాజ్ దిస్ పర్టిక్యులర్ టాపిక్ ఈస్ కన్సర్న్డ్ ఇంటాక్సికేషన్, సెక్షన్ 85 అండ్ 86 ఆఫ్ ఇండియన్ పెనల్ కోడ్ ప్రొవైడ్ ఫర్ డిఫెన్స్ అండర్ ఇంటాక్సికేషన్. సెక్షన్ 85 స్పీక్స్ అబౌట్ వాలంటరీ ఇంటాక్సికేషన్, సెక్షన్ 86 స్పీక్స్ అబౌట్ ఇన్వాలంటరీ ఇంటాక్సికేషన్. వాలంటరీ ఇంటాక్సికేషన్ ఈజ్ నో డిఫెన్స్, ఇన్వాలంటరీ ఇంటాక్సికేషన్ ఈజ్ ఎ డిఫెన్స్, కెన్ బి ఎ డిఫెన్స్. హౌ? వాలంటరీ ఇంటాక్సికేషన్ మీన్స్ ఏ వాంట్స్ టు కిల్ బి, ఇన్ ఆర్డర్ టు కిల్ బి నార్మలీ హీ కెనాట్ వెంచర్ టు కిల్ బి, హీ టేక్స్ ఆల్కహాలిక్ డ్రింక్ అండ్ ఎక్సెసివ్ ఆల్కహాలిక్ డ్రింక్, హీ విల్ గో టు బీస్ రూమ్ అండ్ కిల్స్ హిమ్. దేర్ ఆఫ్టర్ ఏ కెనాట్ ప్లీడ్ ది డిఫెన్స్ ఆఫ్ ఇంటాక్సికేషన్ అంటర్ సెక్షన్ 85 బికాస్ ఇట్ ఈస్ వాలంటరీ ఇంటాక్సికేషన్. ఇన్ ఆర్డర్ టు కమిట్ ఎ క్రైమ్ ఇఫ్ ఎనీబడి టేక్స్ ఆల్కహాలిక్ డ్రింక్ ఆర్ డ్రగ్ ఆర్ సంథింగ్ గోస్ దేర్ అండ్ కమిట్స్ ఎ క్రైమ్, ఇట్ ఈస్ నో డిఫెన్స్. బట్ ఇన్వాలంటరీ ఇంటాక్సికేషన్ మీన్స్ ఇన్ మూవీస్ వీ సమ్టైమ్స్ వీ ఫైండ్ ఇన్ కూల్ డ్రింక్ సమ్ ఇంటాక్సికేటెడ్ సబ్స్టెన్స్ ఈజ్ డ్రాప్డ్ సమ్ డ్రగ్ ఆర్ సంథింగ్ అండ్ దట్ ఇన్ దట్ ప్రాసెస్ ద పర్సన్ థింకింగ్ దట్ ఇట్ ఈస్ ఎ కూల్ డ్రింక్ హీ కన్స్యూమ్స్ దట్ కూల్ డ్రింక్, ఈ బాయ్ ఆర్ గర్ల్, హీరో ఆర్ హీరోయిన్, మ్యాన్ ఆర్ ఉమెన్ థింకింగ్ దట్ ఇట్ ఈస్ ప్రొజ్యూమింగ్ దట్ ఇట్ ఈస్ ఎ కూల్ డ్రింక్, హీ ఆర్ షీ కన్స్యూమ్స్ దట్ కూల్ డ్రింక్. After having consumed that cool drink, the mind becomes out of order. In that process, what he or she is doing, he she doesn't know. And in that process, he or she may commit any crime. Thereafter, he or she can plead the defense of intoxication. So, voluntary intoxication is no defense. Involuntary intoxication is a good defense. In this particular, with this, I will, Bede case is there, voluntary intoxication, Bede's case, and public prosecutor of this case, then cases, Basudev case is there, as a Basudev case versus state of Pepsi. These two points I will explain in detail in next class. And next one is 85, voluntary intoxication, there is no defense. Relevant cases, Bede's case, second one is Basudev's case, 85 and 86. Next one is 87 to 93. There are various instances. Consent. 87 to 93 provide for defense under against consent. What do you mean by consent? Consent means giving acceptance voluntarily. Consent means section 87 to 93 provide for defense of consent. These sections provide various provisions for consent. Consent means if consent is given, there are so many practical examples. Suppose a patient is suffering from serious stomach trouble or some other trouble, then approaches the doctor. Doctor tells, so that is the, this is the problem you are having in this stomach. In your stomach there is some problem. That particular object is to be removed. And if operation is successful, you will survive. You won't get any pain. If operation is not successful, it may cast your life also. So to that extent, you have to give declaration. So this paper signed by the patient, the paper signed by patient to bear with the consequences, that is consent. That is consent. Suppose if he is a minor, on behalf of the minor, parent or natural guardian or legal guardian will sign the papers. At the person from 12 years, beyond 12 years, he has to give, who has completed 12 years, can give the consent. This consent is normal whenever, that is one thing. Suppose when a person is, when a cricket player, he is playing, when he is playing, suppose cricketer, suppose he is hit by a ball and died. Recently, one cricket player died having been hit by cricket ball, you know. So there is no any case, it is consent. Suppose the case is filed against the wrongdoer, he can plead the defense of consent. There are some cases, there are some patients, Euthanasia, I think. That patient is suffering from serious painful disease. There are some cases, the patient is lying on bed in coma for months together and years together. Months together and year together. There is no chance for survival of the patient. And the consent may be given, that is called euthanasia. And therein, that particular patient, if that patient is allowed to be in coma, near and dear are able, can afford to meet the hospital expenses and everything, the patient can be continued for so many days, so many months, years together. Otherwise, either the near or dear can't afford to meet the hospital expenses, nor the patient himself or herself unable to bear with the pains, they may request the authorities to put an end to the life, then it will be done. A consent to that effect is given, and the police officers, so magistrates and all the concerned will be there. In the presence of that, the doctor will give, administer some poisonous injection so as to kill the patient. So that is, in such case, consent is a good defense. When once it is administered, that particular patient is declared dead, the near or dear cannot institute an action against the doctor or others concerned. So consent also is consent is one of the defenses available to the person who is found guilty of an offense. Next, triviality section 95. Next defense is triviality section 95. So triviality section 95. There are commonly, even to speak lie is an offense. Speaking lie is an offense. There are so many in our regular course of life. Section 95 speaks about triviality. There are so many activities, they are negligible activities. They cannot be taken serious. If they can be taken serious, they can be serious. I tell you one example. In Ashby versus White, the person who is prevented from voting was sued. The person, the qualified voter, when he went to polling booth to exercise his franchise, he was denied vote. But the person whom he wanted to vote was declared elected. Still he filed a case. But not like that. So negligible. Suppose we are traveling in a bus. The bus is overloaded. Our body touches another's body. In that process, so little pressing of the body, it attracts battery sometimes. Suppose speaking lie, we say that you are a liar. You are a liar. But liar, it is a defamatory statement. But defamation is a tort and crime. But suppose I say somebody you are a liar, it is actually defamatory statement, but he cannot file a case. Suppose when I want to board a train or a bus running, which is about to move, in that process, I may fall on the body of a, though I am a man, I may fall on the body of a another old woman or even a woman, but still it may be negligible. Case cannot be filed. So triviality means negligible activities. And the next last defense is right of private defense. What is the right of private defense? Section 96 to 106 of the Indian Penal Code lay down various provisions relating to private defense. This topic, insanity, intoxication, private defense, these topics I will explain in detail in next class. Suppose, what is the right of private defense in brief? For example, sections 96 to 106 of 106 of Indian Penal Code provide for various instances of private defense. Suppose I am here, somebody wants to kill me. In order to save myself, I may kill him. Then I can plead the defense of right of private defense. Suppose some watchman or somebody, some dacoits, robbers enter. In that process, that watchman or land the person who is occupant of the house may kill that man who is about to who are attempting to rob the house. So an individual can plead the defense of right of private defense to kill somebody who is about to kill him and who is about to rob his property. Similarly, in ATM, watchman is there. Suppose a gang enters into the ATM mission to rob the money, that watchman may open the fire. Similarly, a watchman in bank, if any dacoits enter into that bank for robbery, that watchman may fire and kill those, and he can plead the defense of right of defense. So in next class, I will take up right of section 84, insanity, 85 and 86, intoxication, section 196 to 106, right of private defense. Thank you very much, dear friends. Please inform your students and subscribe my channel and intimate all your friends for better circulation. Thank you very much.